Okay, so we usually talk about hearts racing, you know, going too fast, but what about the flip side?
Right, when things slow down.
Exactly. We're doing a deep dive today into bradyarrhythmias, so basically heart rates under 60 beats per minute.
Yep, and we've looked at some material that breaks down the different kinds and, well, some of the reasons why this might happen.
So the goal is to kind of get everyone up to speed on this specific slice of heart function, yeah.
Absolutely. And what's interesting right off the bat is that slower isn't always, like, a bad sign.
Oh.
Yeah, the sources mention SA nodal dysfunction. That's the heart's natural pacemaker having issues. But dropping below 60 or even below 50 marked sinus bradycardia, they call it, it can actually be totally normal. Think about, you know, serious athletes.
Right. Their hearts are really efficient, don't need to beat as often.
Exactly. And you also see it sometimes in older adults, just, you know, part of the aging process.
Okay, so the SA node, the pacemaker, just fire slower sometimes.
It can, yeah. The material points to things like increased vagal tone, that's your sort of rest and digest system kicking in maybe a bit too much.
Okay, makes sense.
And also certain medications. Beta blockers are a big
one. Oh, yeah. Definitely know people on those, so that could lower their heart rate.
For sure. And even things like ischemia or infarction basically reduce blood flow to the heart muscle itself.
Wow. Okay, so lots of potential triggers just for that pacemaker slowdown.
Definitely. But then there's the next step. The signal actually getting from the top chambers to the bottom pumping chambers.
Ah, the conduction part.
Right. And that's where AV conduction blocks come in. Think of the AV node like a traffic controller for those electrical signals.
A traffic controller. I like that. So if there's a jam or a disruption.
Exactly. That's what these blocks are.
Mm-hmm.
And there are different degrees, different types of disruption.
Okay. Break it down for us. What's the first kind?
So first degree AV block. It sounds maybe a bit scary, but it's usually just a slight consistent delay.
Just slow traffic.
Kind of, yeah. The signal takes a little longer than usual to get through the AV node. That's a prolonged PR interval on an ECG, if you're looking at that.
Okay.
But interestingly, it's often found in perfectly healthy adults. Usually doesn't need any specific treatment.
Huh. Good to know. Yeah. So what comes after first degree?
Then you get into second degree AV block. And there are two main types here.
Okay.
Type I is also called Mobitz I or Wenckebach. This one has a really distinct pattern.
Which is?
The signal takes longer.
Yeah.
And longer.
Mm-hmm.
And longer to get through with each beat until pop, one beat just doesn't get conducted at all. It gets blocked completely.
So it's like a gradual slowing, then a dropped beat, that Wenckebach phenomenon you mentioned.
Precisely. And the blockage here is usually right in the AV node itself. It can sometimes be temporary too, maybe linked to that vagal tone again, or sometimes issues with the right coronary artery.
Okay. So that's type I. What about type 2? Sounds like it might be different.
It is. Mobitz the second is quite different. Here, the time it takes the signal to get through that PR interval, it stays constant, beat after beat.
Okay, consistent timing.
Right. But then, suddenly, without warning, a beat is just dropped, skipped entirely.
Whoa. So no gradual slowing, just blocked.
Exactly. And the material highlights this often means the problem isn't in the AV node itself, but actually further down the electrical wiring.
Lower down in the system.
Yeah.
And is that more concerning?
Generally, yes. It carries a higher risk of progressing to, well, a more complete block. Management might involve needing electrical pacing to keep the rhythm steady.
Okay, pacing. Right. That makes sense if the signal isn't reliably getting through.
Hmm. Which brings us to the most severe type. Third degree AV block.
Complete heart block. That sounds pretty serious.
It is. This is where there's basically a total disconnect. The signals from the top chambers, the atria, they just don't get through to the lower chambers, the ventricles, at all.
So like complete communication breakdown.
Total breakdown. The lower chambers realize they weren't getting instructions, so they start beating on their own rhythm, driven by an escape pacemaker.
And that rhythm is usually slower, right?
Often much slower, yeah. On an ECG, you'd see the P waves from the atria marching along at their own rate, and the QRS complexes from the ventricles beating at a different, usually slower rate with absolutely no relationship between them.
Wow. So they're just completely out of sync.
Completely dissociated. And because that lower chamber rhythm might be too slow to pump enough blood effectively, this condition definitely requires management, often with electrical pacing.
Got it. So wrapping this up, it's really not just about the number, like the low 60. It's about why it's slow and where the electrical signal is getting messed up.
Absolutely. The location and the pattern of the block tell you so much more than just the heart rate itself. It really underscores how complex that whole electrical system is.
It really does. You know, it makes you think, If something we consider so basic, like a heartbeat, has all these intricate potential failure points depending on fitness, meds, underlying issues, what other bodily functions that seem simple on the surface might have surprising layers of complexity we just don't typically consider?
That's a great point. Lots going on under the hood, always.